Where'd you come from? Done and done. I knew I'd find you. Who's there? Done.
Thank you for breaking that foul vampire's hold over me. Thank the divines for you. I'm quite all right, thanks to you. Dexian Evicus is my name. I'm a moth priest of the White Gold Tower. These vampires claimed they had some purpose in store for me, but they wouldn't say what. Probably hoping to ransom me, the fools. You do? All right then, enough mysteries. Well, you saved me from those vampires. I suppose the least that I can do is hear you out. Very well. I'll hurry on my way there before more of those vampires turn up.
I'm impressed you could find a Moth Priest so quickly. Good. Maybe now they'll afford the vampire threat a tad bit more respect. For the reading? Yeah. Just let the old man know when you're ready.
Perhaps he did it for the attention. Every now and then he'll say something.
Ah, hello there. What can I do for you? Ah, my rescuer. It's good to see you again. It's not exactly the hospitality I'm used to, but your man Isran has seen to my needs well enough. And might I add, this is a remarkable fortress. I have colleagues back home that would love to study this place in detail. Oh, most certainly. Let's find out what secrets the scroll can tell. Now, if everyone will please be quiet, I must concentrate. I see a vision before me. An image of a great bow. I know this weapon. It is Oriel's bow. Now a voice whispers, saying, "Among the knight's children, a dread lord will rise. In an age of strife, when dragons return to the realm of men, darkness will mingle with light, and the night and the day will be as one." The voice fades and the words begin to shimmer and distort. But wait, there is more here. The secret of the bow's power is written elsewhere. I think there is more to the prophecy recorded in other scrolls. Yes, I see them now. One contains the ancient secrets of the dragons, and the other speaks of the potency of ancient blood. My vision darkens, and I see no more. To know the complete prophecy, we must have the other two scrolls. I must rest now. The reading has made me weary.
Come on, old man. You should get some rest.
Do you have a moment to talk? Do you have a moment to talk? That Moth Priest, Dexian, he said we needed two other Elder Scrolls. I think I know where we can start looking. Half the people in your little crew would just as soon kill me as talk to me. That doesn't exactly make me want to open up. I got a warmer welcome from my father, and that's saying something. Ever since he decided to make that prophecy his calling, we kind of drifted apart. I don't even think he sees me as his daughter anymore. I'm just a means to an end. We need to find my mother, Valerica. She'll definitely know where it is. And if we're lucky, she actually has it herself. The last time I saw her, she said that she'd go somewhere safe. Somewhere that my father would never search. Other than that, she wouldn't tell me anything. But the way she said it, someplace he would never search. It was cryptic, yet she called attention to it. If you have a better lead than this, I'm all ears. Besides, I can't imagine a single place my father would avoid looking. And he's had all this time, too. Any ideas? I don't think so. She said she wanted to stay awake in case the situation was resolved. It had to be one of us, and, well, she's so much more powerful than I am. It just made sense for her to be out here. Anything else? Wait, that almost makes sense. There's a courtyard in the castle. I used to help her tend a garden there. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place. Too peaceful. Oh, absolutely. But my mother's not a coward. That is, I don't think we'll actually trip over her there, but it's worth a look. True. But I know a way we can get to the courtyard without arousing suspicion. There's an unused inlet on the northern side of the island that was used by the previous owners to bring supplies into the castle. An old escape tunnel from the castle exits there. I think that's our way in. Don't let me stand in your way, then. I'll be at the dock whenever you're ready.
I wish I could help. The scrolls have changed hands so many times, it's impossible to keep track. Normally, I'd send you to the Imperial City in Cyrodiil to seek answers at the Imperial Library, but that avenue no longer exists. The Elder Scrolls vanished from the Imperial City around 175 of this era and have been scattered across Tamriel by forces unknown. If you want to find the remaining scroll, you'll have to consult with someone versed in magical knowledge. Perhaps at the College of Winterhold?
I'll tell you, the only thing more surprising than hearing from Isran after all these years was hearing that he wanted my help. I immediately realized things must be pretty bad. Looks like I was right. Good day.
I knew it would come to this one day. I knew. And no one believed.
Oh, well, this isn't exactly a palace, is it? Still, it's sturdy, secure, and seems defensible. I suppose I'd rather be here than most other places in Skyrim. If Isran needs me, it must be pretty bad. I wonder what we're up against here. Yes. These vampires are a new threat, and a truly deadly one. Gunmar and I agree that we're going to need Florentius to help. Gunmar and I have a lot of work to do here, so we were hoping that maybe you could track him down. Well, that's the thing. We don't know where he is. I think he had regular contact with the Vigilance, and I know Isran kept track of them. So maybe you could ask Isran if he knows anything? Just keep in mind that
we're not going to have a problem with your little project.
I don't like the idea.
I told you, I'm prepared for this. It's going to work.
There's enough for us to fight out there. I don't need us having to.
I like what he's wrong. Very few people appreciate. It's not easy to get supplies way out here, but I'm managing. Take a look. Farewell.
We don't have many other options. Be on your guard at all times. Avoid sleep if you can. Sleep. Who said something? Sorin or Gunmar? I thought they'd have learned their lesson by now. I don't trust that man. And I don't want him here. I suppose she's right. I shouldn't let my personal feelings get in the way. Last I heard of him, he was aiding the vigilance of Stendard Runvald. He may still be there. If he can maintain some appearance of normalcy, I'll allow him to stay. Keep your eyes open.
For your help, I'm sending word to the Orc strongholds that you're to be trusted. You should be welcome there now. Fight well.
Need something? I'd better get going.
Need something?
I'm ready if you are. Come on, it's just around the side. Castle looks so big from down here. I mean, it is big, but, well, even bigger. Who's there? Done and done. Who's there? Yeah. Take a left up here. This is one of those weird double-barred security measures that my father put in. There. This leads out to the courtyard. Just head for the door. We've made it to the courtyard.
Oh no.
What happened to this place? Everything's been torn down. The whole place looks, well, dead. It's like we're the first to set foot here in centuries. This used to lead into the castle's great hall. Looks like my father had it sealed up. I used to walk through here after evening meals. It was beautiful once. This was my mother's garden. It... Do you know how beautiful something can be when it's tended by a master for hundreds of years? She would have hated to see it like this. Wait. Something's wrong with the moon dial here. Some of the crests are missing and the dial is askew. I didn't even know the crests could be removed. Maybe my mother's trying to tell us something. There's something strange with the moon dial. Very clever, Mother. Very clever. I've never been in those tunnels before, but I'd bet they'd run right under the courtyard and into the tower ruins. Well, at least we're getting closer. Let's go. Getting close, I'm sure of it. I've never even seen this part of the castle before. Be careful. I don't know what might be around. Where'd you come from?
is there. That'll teach you. I knew I heard something. I still remember how to fight. That'll teach you. We're getting close, I'm sure of it. Where'd you come from?
is!
We've reached the top yet. I bet there's some kind of secret passage around here. We're getting close. I'm sure of it. We're getting close. I'm sure of it. Turns out my mother was sneakier than I thought. I wonder what she's hiding. We're getting close. Leave it to my mother. Always smarter than I gave her credit for. Look at this place. This has to be it. I knew she was deep into necromancy. I mean, she taught me everything I know. But I had no idea she had a setup like this. Look at all this. She must have spent years collecting these components. And what's this thing? I'm not sure about this circle, but it's obviously something. Let's take a look around. There has to be something here that tells us where she's gone. My mother was meticulous about her research. If we can find her notes, there might be some hints in there. I had no idea her laboratory even existed. She had an alchemy set up in her drawing room, but nothing that even comes close to what's here. Looking at the equipment and materials, it looks like she was trying to advance her necromancy. I don't know. Certainly not longevity. Kind of a waste of time for a vampire. I remember she used to keep a small journal. See if you can dig it up. Any luck yet? You did? Let me see them. I only know what she told me. She had a theory about soul gems, that the souls inside of them don't just vanish when they're used. They end up in the soul cairn. The soul cairn is home to very powerful beings. Necromancers send them souls and receive powers of their own in return. My mother spent a lot of time trying to contact them directly, to travel to the Soul Cairn itself. That circle in the center of the room is definitely some type of portal. If I'm reading this right, there's a formula here that should give us safe passage into the Soul Cairn. A handful of soul gem shards, some finely ground bone meal, a good bit of purified void salts. Oh, damn it. We're also going to need a sample of her blood, which, if we could get that, we wouldn't even be trying to do this in the first place. Not bad. We'd better hope that's good enough. Mistakes with these kind of portals can be gruesome. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Oh, definitely. Mother would have plenty of those materials in her laboratory. You just need to find them. Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood. Of course. What is it? I've been asking myself the same thing since we came back to the castle. She was so sure of what we did to my father. I couldn't help but go along with her. I never thought of the cost. Neither do I. She always seemed happy before we heard the prophecy. Then it all changed. She became a different person. They both did. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I just didn't expect anyone to care how I felt about her. Thank you. Are we ready then? All right, here goes. By the blood of my ancestors, she actually did it. Created a portal with a soul cannon. Incredible. Incredible. Simply incredible. The Soul Cairn is a tiny sliver of Oblivion, the realm of the Daedra. It's ruled by unseen beings known as the Ideal Masters. Honestly, I don't know. Necromancers are always interested in souls, though, so that probably has some kind of interest. Nobody really knows. As far as I've heard, no one's seen them and returned to Tamriel to tell about it. I've read stories. Stories about fools that manage to communicate with them. You give the Ideal Masters souls, they give you powers to summon the undead. It's all very businesslike. Because most of the stories end with the Ideal Masters duping the necromancers, who end up dead or wishing they were dead. I'm ready when you are. Are you all right? That looked painful. Are you all right? That looked painful. Now that I think about it, I should have expected that. Sorry. It's hard to describe. The Soul Cairn is... well, hungry, for lack of a better word. It's trying to take your life essence as payment. There might be, but I don't think you're going to like it. Vampires aren't counted among the living. I could probably go through there without a problem. Not your first choice, I'd guess? Maybe. We could just pay the toll another way. It wants a soul, so we give it a soul. Yours. My mother taught me a trick or two. I could partially soul trap you and offer that gem to the Ideal Masters. It might be enough to satisfy them. It would make you a bit weaker when we travel through the Soul Cairn, but we might be able to fix that once we're inside. Maybe. I'm sorry. I wish I knew a better way, something that would be easier for you. Just know that whatever path you choose, I won't think any less of you. Sometimes things just have to be done. I know that better than anybody.